For more on the Trump-Bush rivalry and other aspects of the campaign, we're joined by Michael Regan, editor-at-large of Bloomberg News. Michael, good morning.
Oh, good morning.
Trump's even leading right now in the GOP contest in Bush's home state of Florida. The poll this week there had him up 21-17. Is that why Jeb Bush is now on the offensive with Trump?
Well, that and he's leading in Texas, you know, all I can keep thinking about in this relationship is, did you guys see the movie Happy Gilmore?
Yes. Yeah.
So if you remember the plot of that, okay, here's a rough and tumble hockey player who finds out he can hit a golf ball a mile, right? Well, Trump's a rough and tumble businessman who finds out he can go on a political stump speech and hit the ball a mile. And what happens is, what happens in the Happy Gilmore movie is he starts winning, his crowds start getting bigger. Everyone, you know, the establishment hates him, right?
Yes.
But they realize the TV ratings are way up. They realize he's bringing this whole new crowd in to watch golf. And eventually, the other players, the Shooter McGavin, the leader of the tour, starts imitating Happy Gilmore. I think there's a little bit of that with Jeb Bush. He realizes that, and the other candidates too, he realizes that Trump has tapped into this sort of disgruntled nature, anti-establishment feeling that's pretty prevalent in the Republican Party. And so, you know, Jeb Bush, pretty mild-mannered guy, is kind of starting to emulate Trump a little bit.
You say mild-mannered. We heard Trump, in fact, say low energy.
Low energy.
The people that are with him right now are sleeping. Do you think those barbs are starting to work? Because in my eyes, he's still not as aggressive as Trump has been in terms of insults.
Right. Well, yeah, Trump is one of the greatest insult comics of our time. You know, he's like one of these Borscht Belt, you know, comedians from the 50s or 60s. And, you know, for Jeb Bush to start counteracting him and going back at him, it's almost like a rap battle between James Taylor and Eminem. You know, it's a lopsided.
You are just full of them this morning, Michael. I love it. But,
you know, from the beginning, basically all the pundits have felt that Trump ultimately, the air will run out of this.
Right.
Are the pundits wrong? I mean, is there a chance here he could actually win the nomination?
Well, you know, he's got this momentum that just is not going away. The latest Reuters poll last night had him at about 32% out of all the candidates, and Trump and Jeb Bush at 16%. You know, a month ago, it was the same poll was about dead even. So, you know, the question is he peaking too early, or can he keep going? What's amazing to me is here's a guy, he's got a lot of money to spend on ads, but he doesn't have to spend a dime on an ad because the media has basically given up this pretense of equal time for everyone. You know, the cable news is like, look, this guy brings the ratings.
We're going to do it.
And we're going to focus on him.
I'm sorry we didn't have time for Hillary Clinton. I wanted to hear the analogy there. Michael Regan, thank you so much.